course, it's hard to become the best on the high bar in gymnastics, but maybe it's hard to stay at the top. It's really nice when you feel that you still can do it. I don't know how long I can stay at the top, but it's an honor actually if you're the person that they want to beat.
So your first games was in Beijing. How did that help you going into London?
When I did a routine, I wasn't focusing enough on the perfect routine that I wanted to hit, but I was also thinking about what could go wrong, you know. And when it was in the air, I was doubting and I fell down. So I knew that wasn't the right way to attack the final. I learned that when you go to the final, you have to go for your best routine, and that really helped me a lot in the years after. And after Beijing, I didn't make a lot of mistakes anymore.
He cannot afford to move on that dismount. He's got to stand with glue on his feet. Here it comes. And that's a cracker! It's unbelievable! Epke, my son, you've done it. That was fantastic.
Reminders of that incredible final in London 2012.
It was, I think, the best moment of my life during that routine, and especially after it. It was like, I knew that, you know, I could do it. In the training, I did a routine a lot of times, and especially the last 2 weeks before the final, I didn't make any mistakes. And so, of course, I felt really good about it, but still, it was Olympics and the pressure was so high. And you know, you realize that all those people are watching you and that you only have one chance. So it wasn't easy, but it was a really unique routine. And the moment that I stick the dismount, that was really, really special. At that moment, I didn't really realize that I became Olympic champion, I guess. I was really... My goal was to hit my routine, you know, that was the main goal. But to realize that I was Olympic champion, that was really, really strange, yeah.
He's done it! That will tell you, he has done it!
There's confirmation, 16.533! Wow! Epke Zonderland, at the moment, is in the lead. Surely that's where he's gonna stay.
It's gotta be.
What do the Olympic Games mean to you?
It's not the biggest event for your sports, but for all kind of sports. And when you walk in the Olympic venues, you see all kinds of different athletes, and you know the best guys in the world are here. And when you can become the best at that moment in your own discipline, it means a lot. So yeah, it's really great to get that experience. Yeah.
How much do you enjoy pushing the boundaries of your sport?
It's great to find out where the boundaries are for yourself and for your sports. And I think, you know, sometimes you have to do something where you dream about, and maybe you think it's not possible. But especially during the Olympics, I surprised myself that it was possible to do the three flyments in a row. So sometimes you have to follow your dreams.
Do you like the fact that so many people in your sport look to you as a target?
In 2012 and 2013, I won the world title and the Olympic title. So at this moment, I'm the guy to beat, and I actually enjoy it to get in the competition and to do my best to hold on to the title.
What would becoming a two-time Olympic champion means here?
To become Olympic champion one time, it's hard, but to become it in twice in a row, it's really hard, because besides the specialists that are here right now, you get new guys and also have to compete with them, and I have to stay fit by myself for a lot of years in a row. And that's a big challenge, but until now it's going really good.